Welcome back. Let's pretend for a moment that Thanksgiving has already come and gone, and now it's Friday morning, and you're waking up feeling like you overdid quite a bit. Well, there are some things that you can do right away to help, and fitness and nutrition expert Lisa Lynn is here with some tips. Good morning.
Thanks for having me.
You're welcome. So we wake up and we go, ugh.
Yeah, and this, by the way, this is 5 pounds of fat. Everybody sends me emails asking.
Yeah.
So this, just imagine this right here.
Mm-hmm. Right there on the belly.
On your belly. Imagine if you lose this.
Mm-hmm.
I'm actually changing the tagline on my book to lose belly fat fast because I'm getting so many testimonials because there is a system to losing belly fat. We don't just want you to lose weight. We want you to lose this stuff.
Right. And they say you can't spot reduce, but you can maybe target through diet.
You can spot reduce because America's making the mistakes we're going to steer them away from. So
all right.
Let's back up to the night before.
Sure.
This is probably the most unspoken treatment that just no one talks about. Getting a good night's sleep.
Yeah.
So how do you do that? Number one, you avoid alcohol. Believe it or not, disrupts our sleep.
Mm-hmm.
So avoid alcohol, or if you drink alcohol, make sure you could. This is water.
It's water. It's in a pretty bottle, but it's water. All right. You
might
make sure that you put the sleep mask on, or
sleep is critical. So if you're having a hard time with sleep, you might want to block out lights, shut off the phone, shut off the iPads, because they're messing with our circadian rhythms, and that's stopping our sleep. If you can't sleep, you're going to want to take about 5 milligrams of melatonin, which will not slow your metabolism the way other sleep aids will, but it will help enhance it. The last thing you want going into or the day of a cheat day is a slowed metabolism because you took something to make you sleep.
I want it to work well for you. Now, the next morning, I'm guessing that's what the bagel there is for.
Well, no.
Oh, no.
7 hours is key with sleep before we move on. And why is that critical? If we don't sleep, our cortisol levels rise. And when our cortisol levels rise, our fat cells open their doors, hoard fat, and will not let go of it.
All right, 7 hours.
So now we slept our 7 hours.
To get the fat to
go. This is what you don't want to do the morning after, okay? Because here's the thing. What do we always overeat on?
Stuffing.
Fat and carbs.
Right.
So the last thing you need to replace is fat and carbs. You actually have to starve your body of what you overfed, but feed the muscle. So grab a protein shake. What I'd rather people do is eat thermogenically instead, which I get heavily into my book. What does that mean? It produces heat in the body. When we produce heat, it revs up our metabolism, shuts off our appetite and craving switch.
Wow, okay.
So that's critical. We want that. But whey protein shake is the simplest way to do that thermogenically. This will boost your metabolism 25%.
Wow.
Throw some cinnamon on top of that. Now you're dealing with more blood sugar control, and the odds of you burning this are greater.
Okay, we have about 30 seconds left.
All right,
a lot more to
let's
get through.
Go to our next one. So you're going to want to shift out, not have that morning snack. Drink sip hot tea instead.
Okay.
Afternoon snack, green apple to balance blood sugar, and then exercise metabolically. Over-exercise will hurt your metabolism. Exercise incorrect will boost it. So every one of these steps gives your metabolism a hit all throughout the day.
All right, and then just don't do the whole meal over all again on Friday,
That's
and you'll
right.
be okay. All right,
That's
Lisa,
right.
thank you so much
Thanks
for coming
for having
in.
Me.
Stay with us. There's so much more news coming up. You can get her book to learn more tips.